it will decrease. And here the disc space will be increasing. The compression will make, like if you keep a jelly between two layers of disc, press it in the back, it will move back, project in the back. And you press it in the back, it will move it into the back. So we are giving a cushion. Okay? It is necessary for the movements of the spine. Okay? Next, the vertebral bodies transmit compressive forces to the disc, which resists compression by pushing back. So, it acts like a cushion when you jump, or the pressure is from above downwards. When the pressure is from the sides also, they project to the side which the pressure is more, or the force is more. On the other side, it will be trying to balance it, pushing it or moving it. Right. The movement is relative only. The structure stays there only. But when you press the side, when a water bottle or balloon is there, when you press this side, what it will do? It will go to the other side. If you press the other side, it will come to the other side. Now anything you keep on above and below will not, just they will tilt and change the position. So it is not that the bones are moving, but the disc is adjusting front and back. Okay? So there may be a doubt arising if the disc moves away from that area, it will go on compressive spinal cord. It is not so. The disc is firmly held between the bones like this. So the disc will be here like it will. The shape is very big, which will be there inside. So, and the bone surfaces will be slightly curved. The bone which is below will be having curved surface. The bone above also will be having curved surface. So, when the movement comes, it will move easily depending on the action. Okay? So, you know from which place?
Bangalore.
So, you know that title, you know?
Yes.
Like that only the disc is. Not like our ordinary India. So much bunched. Okay? Then. So the second line will come again with the column of arches transmit tension forces to all the attached ligaments, which resist stretching by pulling the back. So once you are stretching out like this, the muscles or the ligaments which are attached to the vertebral column will try to pull it back to the normal shape. It cannot bend for too much of time. So when you maintain a position, you have to come back to the original position. That is another. So next we come to the, these are the applied aspects or the functional aspects of the vertebral column. So we will come to the last is the summary of all the above. The structural elements of the spinal column are involved in an intricate dance that protects the central nervous system by neutralizing the forces of tension and compression. So why these capsular ligaments and what are the role of these ligaments? And the capsule is, the pressure on the spinal cord will be minimized. And when we come to the nervous system, you know that the spinal cord will be within a cover, because it is a spinal cover. In between the, which spinal cord will be in the center, serotonin will be liquid called as cerebrospinal fluid, which acts as a cushion. So the brain is always bathed in a, but the brain, the spinal cord, everything is surrounded by a liquid. The liquid is called as cerebrospinal fluid, which prevents the shock and compression and other forces which are acting upon the brain and spinal cord. If the pressure is more, what will happen in spinal cord area? The spine which is passing through the vertebra, if it is compressed, what will happen? You will generate pain. Many times the headache will be there. So if you relieve that particular thing, you are a dead weight. So that only in asanas or doing asanas, we have to give importance to the structure which is involved, the position which you are taking. Okay? So that only we need to understand the skeletal muscles and all other things which are attached to the skeleton. So, you know, always question that the person who lies down on the snake bed, Vishnu. In Hindu mythology, we have got a god called as Vishnu. He will be told to, what is this color? He calls this like blackish blue. And it's not blue, it is blackish, color they call it as. And Shiva, if you take him also, he is also likely blackish. So, it is nothing but our brain is having a grey matter outside and white matter inside. Because of the grey matter, it appears slightly blackish. And it is bathed within the cerebrospinal fluid. So it is suspended like, what is this? It is suspended within a liquid medium, comfortably sitting. That is the Vishnu, what we call it as. You know that part of it, they call it as the sea. In the sea, you will be having the snake bed and you will be lying there. The snake bed is nothing but the snake is the, what do you call it as, representation of the nadis. You've got nervous system, you've got two things. One is the autonomic nervous system and voluntary nervous system. Or voluntary and involuntary nervous system. They pass through your spinal cord. Okay? And they come out through the gaps which are there between these bones. And the next page you can see the diagram. That is more good. So here in the bones, you can see between the processes or the projections, you can see lines which are connecting them. They are the ligaments. So when they shorten, they will move it like this. When they come back to the original position, the bone will come to the original position. So these are the various parts. If we go and explaining the parts, you get confused. So we'll keep this as it is in the above picture. So these are the bones, and in between is the disc, and then the one attached to the elongation area, this band-like thing is called as the ligaments and the muscles. Okay. So now we will come to the physiology part of it proper. So weight bearing activities. So the first figure, you see weight bearing poses as well as twisting produce symmetrical compression, flattening of the nucleus, which puts pressure on the annulus returning to the spherical shape, thus decompressing the vertebra. So it is a isothetic, that is spherical in shape. So when there is a twist or compression, it will elongate and then it will come back to normal, that is a cartilage. Okay. Second thing is front and back movement. The front and back movement I told you already. The shape will bulge out a little bit back and then it will accommodate the process. Okay, depending on the weight what we are getting. See, this is the title, no? Push and counter push. Back is. When you bend forward, there will be expansion in the back and a compression in the front. When you come back to backward bending, there will be a bulging in the front and the compression in the back. So it is called as push and counter push. One side if you push, the other side will bulge. And the other side if you push, it will be in the other side, it will emerge. So that is what we do here. Forward bending, backward bending and standing straight. So one of the things, what is the benefit of spine is you have a rigid spine which keeps you erect. In animals, the spine is totally towards gravity. So no much pressure is there on the spine of the animal compared to human bones. We have our spine pull is, that is the vertebra is bearing the load and gravity is pulling us. So because of that, it has to work against the gravity. So that only they are firmly tied with ligaments. Okay? So types of spinal movement. That is the part we come with yoga. So what are the possible movements? Flexion. What is flexion? You two can tell. Flexion is one when we move the body parts towards the center of the center line of the body, it is called as flexion. Then extension. When we move away from the center line. That is the imaginary line we keep in the center and we correspond it to that. Then what else is there? Extension and axial rotation. What is axial rotation? Moving around. Okay? Rotating your head, can rotate. Then, here in the spine, it is only the partial movement will be the rotation. That is called a twisting. Twisting means you can stand and you can just turn. And if you are more active, whether it is doing your yoga properly and all the things, you can twist your body to the maximum level. You can see a person called as Baba Ramdev. His videos, if you see, he may be commercial, but his videos, you see, he performs the yoga, his body will be flexing to the maximum level. Okay? And you can watch the Uddiyana Bandha, which he is doing. And then come in lateral flexion. What is that? Side by bending. When we do Trikonasana, you have to bend to the side. Then, see, this flexion where you can go for. Padasthasana, then Pachamakasana, everything. Sitting position, Pachamakasana. One leg flexion, one leg extension, and then you need to do that is flexion, extension. Setu Bandhasana. And then camel pose, what do you call it? Ustrasana.
I don't know.
Karma? Camel pose.
No,
Ustrasana. Ustrasana, yeah. Okay. Yeah. Cat pose, all those things. And then you have got axial rotation. Axial rotation?
Yes.
Yeah, what is that?
I need to be sitting in asana.
இந்த போஸ் பண்ணுறீங்க. Whatever, say clue. Never read out whatever is there as it is. Whatever you know from your field, you are from different fields. You come, you can keep a clue related to that so that you will be easily remembering the things. Okay? Next. Lateral flexion, that is the side bending. And then the four movements occur more or less spontaneously in the course of daily life. We do all these four movements every part of the day without our knowledge. Okay? It is important then. So extension, you can extend to take a thing off and flexion to take a thing from the down. Like the various activities they have given examples. Okay? So and here there is a study which they have found out. The cervical, that is the neck region, you can do extension of 75 degrees, flexion of 40 degrees. Okay? Flexion means, in that we do, Janakara Bandha, you come and touch this chin to
chest.
The chest. Okay. And then you can bend backwards if you have got a very good practice in yoga. You can bend to the maximum of 75 degrees back without falling. That doesn't matter. And then thoracic means this part. The back related to the chest. Okay, upper back. So the upper back, you have got 25% of extension and then 45% of flexion, which accounts totally to 70 degrees of variation. And then lumbar. Lumbar means the one which is in the lower back. That part allows you 35 degrees of extension and 60 degrees of flexion. And then why this degrees of variation has to be known as that? If you know that, or doing yoga, you will not strain. So the basic three things you have to consider while doing yoga is sukha, sthiram, asana. Sukha means comfort. When you do asana, it will give you comfort. Sthiram means stability. Asana means position. So the particular position, if you maintain the position, will help you to build up something in the body. That is nothing but it will be beneficial to the body so that you can live longer. We call it as rejuvenating effect. Okay? It will be more energy. So the difference between physical exercise, that is the what you call it is. You do it in the gym. Regular gym-like exercises and yoga is that. In yoga, after performing, you will not feel tired or exhausted. In yoga, you will have more flexibility and stability. There you will be having more, a rigid form of structure will be coming up. So muscles will be developing nicely. But you will not be having the flexibility related to yoga sessions. Okay? That is the difference. So is there any doubt? Now, here is a graphical representation. There is a diagrammatic representation of the various movements of the spine. So in various yoga exercises, the spine goes to the what do you call it? Flexion, extension, lateral rotation, axial rotation, all these things. Okay? That is being put in a single diagram. So axial rotation is one where you rotate around the first bone is called as the atlas and second one is called as the axis. So axial rotation, the axis bone will be helping you to move your head side to side. Okay, that is being demonstrated here in the picture. Then, when you tilt the neck to the side, it is called a cervical lateral flexion. So whatever we talked before, now it is diagrammatically presented. Okay? So initially if we show you the diagram, what will happen is you will not get understanding, clear understanding of what it is. Then you have got the twisting only of the neck and then the whole of the neck and the body. So the body is also called as the trunk. Okay? So there is the upper part, they show the neck movements, and the lower one they show the full total spine involving the head, sorry, neck and the thorax and lumbar region. So next, this part will be dealt with yoga, surrendering. Flexion, extension, the dynamic. Shurita. So, the very basic movement which is more involved is the flexion of the spine, which will be bending more. Okay, before we saw the graph, no? Or the whatever it is. How much is cervical region, everything. You see, flexion will be having the more degrees. And then, you have that? So the bottom picture, if you see, it is called as a child pose. That is a more safer pose, and there will be no much strain on the spine, and it is slightly curved towards the front. And there will be a curve that will be like this, coming up. So even you see chimpanzees or the monkeys, which are the pre-human animals, they will be having a bend. They will not stand straight. Okay? That is called as a child pose. Okay? So, this is seen in the child which lies within the mother's womb, before born. Okay? It is called as a fetus. And then, you come to the various asanas in which the various poses we can come up with. Savasana or calf pose. The curve of the head of the back of the head, the upper back, the sacrum and the back of thighs, the calves and heels will be seen. So when you lie in Savasana, you will be seeing spaces. Here there will be a space, here there will be a space. And the back when you lie down, here there will be a space. And then here there will be a space. Okay? That is in the lying position. The curvature will be like a S-type. So in the head part it starts like this and then it goes and then it comes up and then in the knee region it will go down and the ankle region it will go. Okay? So this is the way the pose is. There will be, the curvature will be like a slightly S shape in the spine. Okay? So this part is the spinal. That is the left part, okay? So there are few areas which will touch the ground and few areas which will not touch the ground. Okay, these are called as secondary curves. These are called as primary curve. Okay? Like we are talking about the curves of the spine. Okay, the primary curve is one which touches the ground and the secondary curve is one which won't touch the ground. Okay, that is what is to be told here in relation to yoga. When you do your asana, then what else? So when you do spinal flexion exercises, what is the benefit is that? It will increase the primary curves and decrease the secondary spinal curves, thus reducing the tension on the vertebra. That is the application part. You can underline the last line. Spinal flexion can be defined as that part in page 46. The last two lines are there, no? That is the application part. When you are asked in my exam about the importance of spinal flexion, that is the application area. So primary curve is one already, it is there within the body which touches the ground. The secondary curves are those which doesn't touch the ground. Okay? This is what you have to ask. Why it is important? So when you are doing yoga, certain positions, in the lying position, you will be doing Vibhraya Karani. In Vibhraya Karani, you will see that you will support only the gluteal region, that is the better part. And then, when you come to the another Sarvangasana pose, you will be supporting the hip, that is the side of the hip bones, the back, to increase the stability of the shape. Okay? That is the importance. Okay. Now we'll come to the cow pose or the cat pose or chakrasana. In that, you will be lifting your spine back upwards, and then when you breathe out, you will bring it to the extension. That is flexion and extension of the spine, so that it will lift the stretching and the contraction of the spine properly, or the vertebral column, so that the stress will be relieved. So majority of the people in the IT industry now are undergoing the stress due to pressure of the spine. To release this pressure, these asanas will be helpful. So that is what we have come up with. If you want to relax, you can relax.
English means I don't understand.